It's your boy, Joan and Joe. If you don't know, now you know. This whole video about Reggie Bush killing and salary cap. But let's get it, let go. As you can see, win 10 head-to-head salary cap games has already been performed. En route to getting Sean Taylor. So far, he's the best safety in the game. He's a threshold player in that he has his stats are pretty much as high as they can be and get the best animations for each category. And he's pretty much just a game breaker in the left side of your field. Or the right side, or the whole field. I played against somebody. They took Sean Taylor to the same side as the strong safety. And when the play started, swung him to the left side and made a play on the ball. They didn't get the interception, but it was just crazy. You had to have been there to see. Of course, I didn't record it, you know. But anyways, people don't know how to win head-to-head salary cap games. And, you know, because they make it more complicated than it has to be. So, what you want to aim for is you want a quarterback who can scramble in order to get open. You need to be able to not get sacked. You need at least 77 speed. You also want your quarterback to be able to throw. Once you combine those two things, you're going to cost at least 30 salary. Now, the cheapest you can get at, actually, the best quarterback you can get for a cheap price is Dan Marino by far. It's not even close, but his speed is only 54. It's trash. Any defensive tackle is going to get him. The moment you press R2 to try to scramble, he's going to take forever to turn his feet the opposite direction. It's going to be automatic sack. But his throwing stats are very, very good for no contact points. As opposed to somebody else with 25 contract. As you can see, Steve Jones really fast, 80 speed, with throwing and stuff is just terrible. Nothing, throwing power is above 75, but that's it. Throwing a run is above 75. Everything's below 75 except throwing power and throwing a run. That doesn't help you at all. Same thing with Bo Jackson. He's got high throw power and high throwing a run, but nothing is above 75. You can't throw anything close to a dot, dot, dot. That's what you want to do. You want to throw them dot, dot, dots. You want it to be Dottyville. You want it to be dot gang, dot mob, all of that. You want to throw them dots. You can't do that with them trash stats. Yeah, Devin Wade, a lot of people like to use him. He's trash, you know. He has high throw power with low throw accuracy deep. It doesn't balance out. You can throw it far, and it doesn't get to where it needs to go. It's an automatic pick, you know, or it goes out of bounds. It's just trash. That's a trash stat combination. 76 speed is decent, but it's not 77. Phillip Rivers is the best quarterback you can have for low contracts in general, but the same problem with Dan Marino. His speed is doo-doo. He gets caught by any defensive tackle. Doesn't even have 60 speed. Case Keenum is really good at throwing. He has 77 speed. Doesn't really have a weakness. Great quarterback. Now, these team leader 86 overall quarterbacks are going to be really good for you, but their problem is going to usually be speed. Tyrod Taylor is pretty decent, but his throwing stats aren't really that decent. So for these other guys, just accept it. You're going to be scrambling just to get away from the sack. You still need to throw it. You scramble to create space, then you have to set your feet and throw it. Even though Andy Dalton actually has high. Well, Case Keenum too, they actually have high throwing and run, so they actually can throw while they're running. But don't try to scramble for a first down if somebody's chasing you. You only get, like 1 or 2 yards. But sometimes it's better than incompletion. But that's not the point of this. The point is, you want speed to be above 70. I said 77 originally, completely scratched that. You want speed to be above 70. You want throwing power to be relatively high. You want throwing accuracy deep to be above 77. So, you want to aim for, you know, if you got long shot Dan Marino, use him. Just remember, he's terribly slow. You have to remember you can't run with him. Same thing with Phillip Rivers. You have to remember you can't run with him. Case Keenum or any other mobile quarterback, I say mobile, not freaking Mike Vick type guys. You know, they're mobile. As in they can move. They can escape. Escape, not create. Don't be trying to expect a 40-yard run with a Case Keenum. 25-yard maybe, depending on what kind of route she had going on. It's a whole nother video. Anyways, these are the quarterbacks you want to aim for. Andy Dalton, team leader. Case Keenum, football outsiders. Phillip Rivers, gauntlet champions. Long shot Dan Marino. Yo, you need to throw these freaking dots. Dot, dot, dot. Dot gang. Dot mob. All of that. Or you can say screw all that, get you one of these advanced like 92 overall Mike Vick. I got 91 overall Randy Cunningham. He's just been throwing dots for me anyways to go along with the 79 speed. So, you know, but more importantly, save your contract. Don't use any salary on their running back. I have footage of me freaking beasting on Reggie Bush. Let's look at these stats. Oh my gosh. 45 carrying, 46 minute, 47 elusiveness. I mean, he's basically like a fast guy from off the street that like broke his Achilles or something. Like he can run really fast in a straight line, and if he jukes somewhere, he like falls on his own. 36 trucking, that's just trifling. That's crazy. He's 6 foot. You don't tell me you got a grown man 6 foot tall at 36 trucking? Anyways, all you need for your running back is above 81 speed. You want above 81 speed and above 84 acceleration. You want to break that 85 and up threshold for acceleration. Anything below 84, you're in trouble. There are plenty defensive ends that have 84 acceleration. They're going to catch you when you try to go around the edge. 84 and above, 85 and above acceleration, 81 and above speed. You don't need breakaway speed. And if you go anything higher, if you go too much higher than 81 speed, you'll break into a whole nother salary range. So, you know, you go from 14 to 17. Like, 3 doesn't sound like a lot, but you know, can kind of make or break you when you get into your prime position, the positions that need to have high contracts. Speaking of which, the footage for the Reggie Bush is like, you know, I got people quitting, man. Like, nobody. Like they pause the game, look to see who I got on my thing. They're like, man, you know it's with Reggie Bush, and they just don't play anymore. For wide receivers, you want 6'3" and above receivers, and you want them to be the speed just needs to be above 85. Not too many fast 6'3" and above receivers. You know, the highest contract player I have is Calvin Johnson at 56. The highest overall receiver I have is actually Michael Irvin. But the reason Calvin Johnson costs more contracts is because he jumps higher and he's taller. It gives you a whole nother range. It gives you a whole nother threshold for animation. That height with that jumping. And you don't really want to resort to animations, but you always want the possibility. Because that's how you counteract defensive thresholds. Like zone coverage at 91 and above, and man coverage at 90 and above. You know, hit power, not hit power as much, but That's how you counteract the defensive threshold. You have to have players that are 6'3 and above. You know, which doesn't really help you against Richard Sherman, but you have to have players who are relatively taller than the people that are trying to guard them, and they have to be able to jump higher. So we've got, you know, can't use the Calvin Johnson 56 contract. That's way too much. So you're going out for 6'3". You got Devontae Parker, team leaders. I actually didn't have him when I was playing squads. Great addition to the team. I went the whole Jaguars route. I used both 6'3" receivers, Allen Robinson. He has team leader's ability, and I used Allen Hurns, 6'3", 81 jumping, not really as high as we want, 82 speed, relatively slow, but the point is he's 6'3", and he's a Jaguars player, so he's getting that Jaguars team leader boost, so his run blocking is relatively high. Now, the player I have that nobody knows about, that was freaking beastin' for me in squads, was Josh Gordon. Oh my gosh. Freaking killing dudes. Like, between Reggie Bush and Josh Gordon, like, you know, I got like 4 or 5 people to just quit. I mean, and I know it wasn't because I was just killing them in general, because it's squads and everybody's pretty much playing, not squads, head to head. Everybody's playing salary cap head to head. Everybody's playing it because they're trying to get Sean Taylor. Some people are playing it so that they don't have to deal with the people who pay for their team, which made it pretty fun, actually. I enjoyed not going against people whose teams were way better than mine because they spent money on the game. But, you know, it's a lot more balanced as far as your team goes. You know, of course there are going to be players on the field who are freaking beasts, but it balances out when they have to have bums elsewhere. But this Josh Gordon at 6'3 with 89 speed, that's freaking crazy. Like Julio Jones, AJ Green type stats right there. Like nobody else that tall has that kind of speed. Like, you know, we just gotta take a moment of silence for that. Like, they gave Josh some credit. Nobody knows they gave him credit, but they gave him some credit. Now, then they dookied on him with all his other stats, but he has 85 jumping. So with that 6'3" height and the 85 jumping, we break that threshold, and we get those jumping animations along with the 89 speed. I didn't need to use the animations. My Josh Gordon, with the routes and things that I do and the way that I force defenses to respect certain routes, he was just open by himself in the backfield with that 6'3 long gazelle stride by himself. And they're just like, who was that? And they're like, what, Josh Gordon? Oh my God. Yeah, it's all of that. So he's worth the contract. See, he's a contrast beast that's not a budget beast. He's just salary cap dogging people out. But the footage with him is a whole nother video. The trick to the Reggie Bush thing is the line. Cordy Glenn, team leaders, 26. He's not as good as Nate Soldier, but he doesn't suck. Keeps that here strength, 89 strength. Who else has that? Nobody. I jest. Of course other people have it, but they don't have it with other balanced out stats. And he's only 26 contracts. Quentin Spain, another team leader. Titans, giving us that run block for all Titan players. 85 run block, 87 pass block, for 86 overall. Pretty nice. 27 contracts. It's freaking amazing. Greg Manx. Could have used Alex Max at 30, but decided it wasn't working. Didn't need the center to be too big, so not really going to be trying to power it through the middle too often. You want to power it for inside zones, but not really dives. But if you wanted to do the dives, then of course the center would be more important. But I went with Greg Maddux and decided to do more inside zones. I don't really like sweeps too much because there are times when they can sniff it out and they might just blitz you with the linebacker and destroy your life. And with that freaking 40-something carry that Reggie Bush has, you don't want to play around with plays where, you know, they can get to you before you can protect the ball. So inside zones and stretches are where you're going. And you don't really need an extreme center for that. So skipped on the center one with the go deep chemistry. And the right guard, didn't say any contracts here. Just use the best guard I had at the time. Larry Little for 88. Something like a big deal. He's got a go deep chemistry. Give us that pass blocking. And another team leader, Jaguars, to go along with our receivers that we had out there. And you see, 84 run block, 87 pass block, 88 awareness. So he's not letting freaking Jadeveon Clowney bust through your line. You know, no J.J. Watt, no crazy stuff. You know, he's picking up, and with that high awareness, he's picking up when Von Miller gets beside him, he's picking that up. You know, we need that out there. You know, we got Brian Bulaga to compare the stats. You know, 83 run block versus 84, 87 versus 91 pass block, you know. You know, it's subpar. It's definitely not a bomb anywhere. And, you know, it's pretty good. And that's what you gotta do. You gotta find these freaking beasts. Oh, I forgot to comment on freaking, you know, salary points. You know, a whole 7 lower. So you're saving, man. It's all about budgeting with them salaries. And for tight end, you know, at first I went with Jason Peters out of position, but I needed my tight end for fourth downs. And with Jason Peters, I didn't have that. So I switched him out to kick off Gronk. You know, they're the same contract, same salary, but I just, you know, I could use Gronk with his route running a little bit more. And his, you know, spectacular catches a little bit more. Like, I could throw an out route to him and he would, you know, tiptoe. Whereas Jason Peters is way too heavy for all that. You know, I gave up a lot of run block protection. But Gronk isn't a super run block bum. So, you know, he's a regular tight end blocking. So. Here we go with what you was waiting for. Everybody want to see how can Reggie Bush possibly do anything. I'm telling you, man. Reggie out here getting 50, 60 yard runs, dog. With no fumbles the whole game, bro. Ooh. Hey, ho! Look at that whole bet. What are you doing? Oh, little boy. Little boy thought it had a play. He ain't do nothing but make my day. Come on, Reggie. Reggie, he can't. He don't even know how to run angles. There's a whole field to this right side of the field, bro. You don't need 90 speed when you run the field like me. That's a poem written by Reggie. God dang it, Reggie B. Come on. Reggie B for the TD. Oh, still going. Ooh, we got a pancake over there. Oh, man. You cannot afford to miss that first tackle. Ooh, angles. Oh, man. Michael Vick, you so out of position. See what I did there? Because you're out of position to make the tackle. And he out of position because out of position Mike Vick that play cornerback. Oh, man. Too much sauce. Okay, too much cheese. Man, what we going to do here, Reggie? You is not going to score twice in the same quarter. Reggie, you doing, and you about to Gronk. I'm like, nah, Reggie, I can't show him all that. You can't do the Gronk spike on him, Reggie. Because Gronk is on his team. That's just chopping it. Come on. Now what we gonna do here? Cause I know Reggie ain't about to kill him. Reggie ain't got no more yards left in you. Why it look like he about to hand it off? Ain't no way. Reggie, ooh Lord, Reggie, you said screw that hole. Reggie said, I ain't about to get met by nobody. Whoop! Hit that other hole. Man, ain't nobody back there, Reggie. Reggie, this is a ranked salary cap game, Reggie. You're not allowed to do... Ooh. Reggie, since when you got a juke move, Reggie? I thought you had like 40 juke move. Where did juke move come from, Reggie? You left from stanking. That ain't even right. Oh, man, Reggie. You gotta... This stuff you doing to him just ain't right, Reggie. So I gotta... You gotta chill. Now, what we gonna do here? We got... Ooh. Oh, man. Wait a minute. I need some help. Somebody. Anybody. Okay. It's Reggie. Reggie, you got like 40 catching. Now you out here catching balls, right? Ah, Reggie, you got like 300 all-purpose yards, man. Reggie, that is crazy that you're doing them like this. I cannot believe it. Reggie, you really got to chill out now. We got somebody else got to do something. Somebody else. Reggie, they tired of you, Reggie. They sent it all out. They sent that blitz, Reggie. So I just sent everybody to where I thought the blitz was coming from. Look at it, Gronk. What are you going to do, Gronk? Protect the ball? Because you got a low overall. I said, now pay attention to me now. Pay attention. Give it to him. Gronk. Protect the ball because you got a low overall. That's what you got to do, man. You ain't got to worry about nothing. It's about your play calling, bro. Like... The players is just humans. Everybody human. Look at it. Somebody look at this, please. Look at this old field. Ain't nobody open, man. People in my way. It's like I lied, man. I'm throwing dots. Look at it. Look. Oh, toe tipping for no reason. Oh, he about to Gronk spike and Gronk. I just said we're not doing that to him. That's not nice. That is not nice. I can't show that. I'm not allowed to show that. Can't show nobody Gronk spiking out here, man. They're just trifling. Reggie got like 300 all-purpose yards. Gronk out here getting five plays in the same drive and scoring. What? Oh, man. Look at Gronk. Gronk getting double teamed out here, man. But it looked like a double. It looked like a cover three. What you do with that cover three? You attack the gap. And when I attack the gap, something gonna happen. What that out there? What who that there that say they gonna beat them armadillos? I don't know. But I'm gonna throw it to him though, cause he's 6'3". Oh man, he's so heavy. Look at him take that hit. And keep the ball. Take the hit and keep the ball with a low overall. That's what it's all about, man. That's just to keep the drive alive. This right here is to win the game. After Reggie Bush and carried us, Gronk walked us over here. Now I just need my quarterback. Give it to your quarterback. See how he's going to act. I said, give it to your quarterback. Whoa, bro. The play ain't over there, man. What you doing, man? Oh, he wide open. Oh, you just going to walk it off on him. Oh, he's going to walk out the game like that. That crazy, man. That's just crazy. Damn, man. Reggie Bush out here killing. Kickoff 70 overall. Gronk killing. Whew, man. But this your boy Jonah and Joe. Just in case you ain't know, now you know. And that's how you gotta handle them boys on head-to-head salary. I'm out.